Запрошую до слова.
Now the floor is given to Colonel Maxim Prauta, Ministry of Defense of Ukraine spokesperson on NATO-related issues. Good afternoon. Undoubtedly, the main event of the last 24 hours was the visit of the President of Ukraine to the line of confrontation and the appointment of the commander of the joint forces. But now about the situation at the line of confrontation. During the last 24 hours here, relative calm was observed, but the militants of Russian occupation forces were not fully committed to the ceasefire regime. One precision enemy shelling was recorded in the Lugansk sector. Starting 9:20 p.m. for 1 hour, the enemy delivered fire using weaponry of IFVs and large-caliber machine guns against our defense positions near Troitske from the side of Sanzharivka village that is occupied. The servicemen of the armed forces of Ukraine that implement combat tasks at the line of confrontation continued to strictly adhere to the Minsk agreements and didn't return fire. In the result of enemy shellings, no serviceman was wounded or injured. The situation in the region of ATO is under control of our servicemen. According to information provided by the main intelligence department of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine, the center of information counteraction of southern military district of Russian armed forces in Novocherkassk started preparation of one more series of anti-Ukrainian fake videos in temporarily occupied territories of Donbas, including on the 5th and 16th of March this year in settlements of Novoazovsk region of Donetsk Oblast. Specialists of the center, together with the militants and military equipment of one of the military units of so-called First Army Corps of Russian occupation forces, carried out shooting of a sham video to fabricate untrue messages about so-called violations of ceasefire by Ukrainian side, and the representatives of Russian media and so-called deputies of Russian occupation administration participating in the work of this video shooting. On the 16th of March, the President of Ukraine, Supreme Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Ukraine, Petro Poroshenko, visited the operational area, including freed Katerinivka. He was accompanied by the top officials, including Minister of Defense of Ukraine, General of the Army of Ukraine, Stepan Poltorak, Head of General Staff, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Ukraine, General of the Army of Ukraine, Viktor Muzhenko, Commander of ATO Forces, Lieutenant General Mikhail Zabrodsky. Head of State spoke with local residents. We need to start peaceful construction. We will do everything possible in order to achieve peace as soon as possible, to restore peaceful life. We are for our flag, and we will never give land and people to anyone else, Petro Poroshenko stated. And also the President of Ukraine visited the Zolote entry-exit checkpoint that is near Katerinivka village. It is about 300 meters from the line of confrontation. He stated that the work of this checkpoint is constantly blocked by Russian occupation forces. Ukrainian side fully ready to start the work of checkpoint, and it is extremely important for the whole world to see that here Ukrainian president is standing and we implement the agreements we have undertaken, and we do everything possible in order to improve the lives of people who, in the result of aggression of Russian Federation, found themselves in the occupied territories, Petro Poroshenko added. Supreme Commander-in-Chief visited our servicemen at the front line. Petro Poroshenko signed a decree to appoint to the position of Commander of Joint Forces Lieutenant General Sergei Naev. In the course of the military service, Sergei Ivanovich Naev went a long way, starting being platoon commander to deputy head of General Staff of the Armed Forces of Ukraine. The President expressed conviction that the level of training, experience of leadership and bodies of military command of different level will allow Lieutenant General Sergei Naev in a good way and responsibly command forces and means of the armed forces of Ukraine and other military formations to repel and deter Russian aggression against Ukraine. Head of State, in the course of the meeting with the servicemen, stated that the law on the peculiarities of state policy to ensure state sovereignty of Ukraine in temporarily occupied territories in the Donetsk and Lugansk oblasts There is a strategy envisaged for reintegration of Donbas into Ukraine and restoration of territorial integrity of Ukraine in its internationally recognized borders. And we change format of this operation, and the command goes to the armed forces of Ukraine. This operation is changed to the operation of joint forces. The president stated and added that representatives of military formations and law enforcement bodies that participate in the mission will also be transferred under command of joint forces. The president of Petro Poroshenko, in the course of the meeting with defenders of Ukraine, signed the law concerning provision to contract servicemen of the right to get monetary compensation for housing rent. Its norms envisage the removal of social injustice that exists concerning the provision to servicemen of the right to get monetary compensation for housing rent. Previously, this compensation was envisaged only for officers and military students. And now it can be provided to servicemen, such as private sergeants and first sergeants, who serve under contract in places of deployment where housing resources are not available. The head of state also visited our wounded servicemen in hospital, and he spoke with the servicemen and thanked them for the defense of Ukrainian land against aggressor. Thank you very much. This is all.